Yeah, Marissa, that engineer says these kinds of ship strikes on bridges are rare, but they do happen. And it's something that bridge designers have worked to account for in recent decades. Erin Bell is the chair of civil and environmental engineering at UNH. She says it was actually another famous bridge collapse just a few years after the key bridge was constructed that was led to all the changes to address these kinds of problems. Baltimore's key bridge was built in the 1970s, but in 1980, the Sunshine Skyway Bridge in Tampa, Florida was also struck by a large ship that sent 1,200 feet of road down into the water below. Since then, Bell says new bridges have been built with a number of fail-safes to better protect against passing ships. There are a few different methods, but each essentially works like the rubber on the outside of a bumper car, meant to deflect passing ships and protect the bridge's main supports.
We've learned a lot about what we should do from a redundancy standpoint to protect our bridges, these protection islands and the dolphins and the fender systems, that really a lot of that changed after the Sunshine Highway collapse in 1980.
And Bell says that there is going to be a lot to learn from the investigation into that bridge's collapse, including whether or not the bases of the key bridge will be reusable in any reconstruction process. She says that could have a big impact on the timing and cost of rebuilding that bridge. Live in the newsroom, Ross Ketchke, WMUR News 9.